Liberty Township teenager accused of setting his house on fire to kill his parents went before a judge. He may soon be facing attempted murder and arson as an adult. WLWT News 5's Karen Johnson live outside the Butler County Juvenile Courthouse with the latest. Karen.
Well, Lisa, up until today, the teenager and the parents, they have not been allowed to have contact with one another. So as you can imagine, it was fairly emotional inside the courtroom. We are not identifying the teen because he's only 16 years old. And as it stands right now, proceedings are still here in juvenile court. But I can tell you he walked slowly into the courtroom today, not much expression on his face. I didn't see him make eye contact with his parents either as he took his seat next to his attorney. The Lakota West student is accused of setting his Tarragon Court home on fire. Prosecutors say he set fire to two different spots in the upstairs hallway while his parents slept in separate bedrooms. Investigators say he intended to kill his parents, tied at least one of their bedroom doors shut, even had a blueprint of how he was going to do this. Because of his age, if the judge finds probable cause at a hearing that's been set for later this month, the teen will be tried as an adult.
There have been many efforts and attempts to portray this kid as something that he's not and something much worse than what he is. He's still a 16-year-old kid. He's a scared kid. He's got rights. There are a lot of things that have to happen before he can be put in an adult prison, which is what we've seen as everyone's goal to this point.
Before the teenager left the courtroom today, he was allowed to talk briefly with his parents. He walked over to his mother, who was crying. They hugged each other. She said, "I will be here. I love you." Then he walked over to his father, who was in a wheelchair, presumably from the injuries from the fire. They shook hands. And at that point, from where I was sitting, I was able to hear sniffles. And it appeared at that point that's when the teen may have started crying. Reporting live in Hamilton, Karen Johnson, WLWT News 5.